Energy crew, I hope you're all well. It's your girl, welcome to Shan, aka your source of energy. My content ranges from challenges, basketball and lifestyle videos, and an abundance of energy from yours truly, your source of energy. Do you see how it links? That's why I'm gonna say welcome to Shan, aka your source of energy, because I'm your source of energy and you lot are a part of the energy crew. You're only a part of the energy crew if you hit that subscribe button, okay? Did you get it? Cool. So if that's something that interests you, you should definitely click that subscribe button at the bottom of your page and turn on the notification bell to ensure that you're up to date with my videos, which is now changed to every 2 weeks, every fortnight, twice a month. Well, twice a month. My apologies, I actually didn't mean to swear at you guys. I'm sorry. It's been a long time. I shouldn't have left you without a cool story. Step two. I'm not gonna lie, I'm definitely gonna be using that as an intro for my story time. So when you hear it's been a long time, I shouldn't have left you. Just know that there's a story to follow, because that's my new intro. I'm in one of the best moods, and it's quite ironic because I've literally just come back from the hospital, and that's what I'm doing the story time for, to update you on what's been going on in my personal life. So grab some popcorn. You grab some popcorn because this is sweet and salty. I got my crisps. But yeah, honestly, oh, there you go, I've given it away. But it's actually grabbed my attention that not everyone knows about it. I have actually posted what's happened to my finger on my other social platforms, which is my Instagram, my Snapchat, which I think you should get interactive with. But it's time to attend to the main platform where my beautiful subscribers are. Again, thank you for 532 subscribers. You guys are amazing. I'm gonna keep creating. I'm gonna keep laughing. I'm gonna keep on exerting my energy, because you lot make me do this. This energy is all for you. Grab it. Digest it, drink it, eat it, whatever, man, just keep it. But my aim is to ensure that when you watch my videos, you've laughed at least once, and to ensure that your serotonin is increased significantly after watching my videos. So I thought I'd come to the platform, save my energy, and just let everyone know the full story behind this injury and how it initially began and the processes that I've had to take in order to get this freaking splint on. Should I start? Story time. All right, so what actually happened with my finger? This Morocco over here, yeah, has actually been sprained for 2 years. So, happened on the basketball court. Everyone who knows me knows that I ball. I'm a semi-professional baller, and I need to start saying this with more confidence, because not a lot of people know I'm semi-professional. I'm gonna hold that title high. I'm also number one in the country. If you didn't see my previous video, you better go check it out, because I'm number one in the country right now.
Period. Period. Period.
The injury actually occurred on my home outdoor court, in Turnpike Lane. I was playing one-on-one with a boy, I don't even know who he is, like, I think it was king of the court. And it was getting rowdy, it was getting heated, it's a nice summer's day, no rain, like, hot, everyone's just there cooling with their drinks, the 1 pound slushies that we get from the tube station. Oh my god, that Turkish lady, God bless her, because the way she's there, without fail, every year, just providing hand cups. I think I've been to her about 3-4 times a day. Let me tell you, them slushies, yeah? Fantastic. But what happened was, playing King of the Court, crossed the guy, everyone was like, whoo! And this is not the guy that injured my finger. But yeah, the crowd was just like, what? And I was just like... All the boys that generally go there, that those are my guys, you know what I mean? They're, everyone that knows me there knows that I can ball. But then when the new guys come and they're just like, oh, there's like only one girl there, they automatically think that you can't play, and that really irks me. I swear, it could be anyone. It really irks me. It's just like, bruv, if you don't hold your ankles tight, I might just snatch them. So I did a little 1-2 crossover, you know. and crowd went wild. And the next contestant came through, i.e. the person that injured me. And like, obviously the crowd got hyped, so he wasn't trying to be embarrassed like the poor guy that got crossed. And he ran into my finger whilst on defense. So my finger went, okay, let me not demonstrate on the finger that's affected, but my finger went back and up at the same time. I was in Spain without the S. My chest was burning, but because of the adrenaline fueled in me, I kept playing. Shortly after the incident, I did take myself to the hospital where they did an x-ray and they told me, oh, nothing's wrong with your finger. Nothing's wrong. Seems like everything's fine to us. There's no fracture, no break. You're okay. Just give you a packet of paracetamol and we'll send you on your way. And we'll send the x-ray image to your doctor. At this point, you can imagine I'm in excruciating pain, but I'm not displaying it because everyone's pain tolerance is different. So I've gone and I'm like, okay, well, I'm in a lot of pain. There's no way you're telling me that there's nothing wrong with my finger, because if you can, like the size as well, my fingers, don't mind my nails because the nail shots are closed and we're in a pandemic, so shut your teeth. The size of my finger that was affected and the rest of my fingers, if you can see briefly right now that my fingers are like very slim. The size in itself should be a sign. Evidently there's something wrong with my finger, because it wasn't like that before the incident. So can you do something more than just give me paracetamol? But apparently because I wasn't displaying enough pain, it wasn't taken into consideration and therefore it was left untreated. I think it just bugs me that you spend several years in education to send someone who has sprained ligaments home with paracetamol and a misdiagnosis. You're absolutely rude. I'm not even about to cuss no one's son on this platform, because that's not what I'm here for. I'm here to just tell you my experience and how out of order some people in the NHS are. And it's so ironic because I actually work with the NHS, which is probably why a lot of people didn't ask me what's wrong or how's your finger, because they probably thought I was just going to work for a normal shift. It is what it is, now you know. But I can't lie, I'm just really happy that this injury is taking place. Well, not taking place, because as I said, it was an injury from 2 years ago. And it only this is how it sparked up. It sparked up because I actually hit it on a box at work. I was taking out drugs from the box. If you don't know my occupation, I'm a qualified dispenser and I work between hospitals and chemists. I've got a permanent job in a chemist right now, and I kind of neglect the weekend jobs in the hospital because, you know, we're in a pandemic and I'm not trying to catch anything because I live with vulnerable people. So an injury that was left untreated from 2 years ago has now been triggered by a box, literally a cardboard box. I just hit it, went poof, and that's it. My finger started aching. It was inflamed. It was really painful, actually. And that's when they told me about like the sprained ligaments, and it was just like, ah, if you had told me 2 years ago. But as I said before, I have literally just come back from the hospital where they've given me a brace and they've actually strapped it with compression bandages, which is doing quite a good job. I think this is the second week with me having a brace on. I had a blue one on previously, for those who actually saw it when I first posted on my social media. But it's healing up really good. I have a finger specialist called Leslie, and she's amazing. And she's literally spoke me through all the rehab processes and the exercises that I would have to continuously do, obviously in order to reduce the size of the swelling, because the swelling is still quite bad. And I'm not gonna lie, for the first week of having the brace on, I have lost several hours of sleep because this pain was really paining me, you know. It was like that sharp pain you see when you have like pins and needles in your foot. Yeah, that's what I'm feeling currently in my finger. It's just although I'm itching to go out and play, I mean, it does give me the necessary time to heal up before the season starts again. Hopefully, fingers crossed, September or October, whenever it restarts, we should be out of lockdown and back into tiers or no tiers at all. As I said, I'm just happy that it's not during a regular season where there's fans and the atmosphere is just not the same. So all I can say is praises to the Lord above, because had it been a regular season and I'm injured now, golly, I don't know why I'd be crying, you know? But I hope you guys are just prioritizing your mental. As I said, you just need to stay on top of things. How I'm staying on top of things is I have the right people around me. I've got timetables around me, literally. I'm not going to show you because I can't be asked to get up, but I've got timetables around me. If you have me on social media, then you'll have an insight to it, so you should probably follow me on social media. But timetables are essential and it really does keep me on track on my daily routines. Drinking a lot of water. Yeah, I'm about to drink some now. So watch me. Yeah, okay. Keep your mind clear of negativity. So if someone's bothering you, they don't need the explanation of why they have to leave your life. They just need to go. Yeah. No. Oh my God. The next one is going to be some juicy topics. I can't wait till the next story time. You are going to be intrigued. But seriously, just keep your minds positive. Stay afloat. You know, and don't let this lockdown make you lazy. Just be as productive. I'm not even trying to be a, what's that word? A hippo. Yeah, a hippo. A hypocrite. Because I have been procrastinating a bit. And obviously that's due to the injury and just lockdown in general. It is very draining mentally and physically. But just try and keep on top of things. And that's what I'm doing. You know, I'm creating content right now. I could be using the pandemic as an excuse not to create content for you guys. And I'm not going to do it because I told you it either makes or breaks you. And you can't break you. You just can't do it. This finger is already breaking me. I can't let any more things break me. Yeah, so I hope you finally got understanding. This just relieves me of all the other people that I need to tell. If anyone asks me, oh Shan, what happened to your finger? I can now just say, just go on my YouTube. I've explained the full story instead of repeating myself over and over again. You know how stressful that is, like. You know what I mean? Almost fell off my chair. But yeah, guys, if you like this video, please make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. Here we go. This is the crackhead energy coming out towards the end of the video. I'm tired. I feel like the craziness is gonna spew out through the rest of my videos. I ain't gonna change. You're just gonna see this. I'm like, yeah. If you like this video, please like, comment, and subscribe. And let me say it with more intensity. If you like this video, make sure you like, make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. Because if you don't subscribe, you're a mother hooker. No, seriously, you're a mother hooker if you don't subscribe. And the next topic, I said, the next story time is going to be very juicy. Okay? Thank you so much for, you know, listening to my TED Talk. I hope you guys have a splendid evening. My good chums, my energy crew, that. I'm too excited. I need to relax. But yeah, thank you guys. I love you guys so much. We're on the road to 600 subscribers. Woo! All right, so it's time for me to go. Bye. Do you like my top, by the way? Basketball is my girlfriend. See, this is what keeps me happy. I'm not even going to tell you where I got it from because the person's not getting it back. If you're watching it, you're not getting it back. Bye. Bye. She got a thing.